So, Sifu, the movie title is Gato in Sea. Those are also the words written on the Ip Man bust in his museum in Fatsa. Could you tell us more about this meaning, please?
Actually, this title present, I think it was very well translated as a Grand Master, not just Grand Master, Grand Master. As a leader of one whole generation. So it's a very interesting part because there is a lot of discussion what really to be one person considered a grandmaster, or more, grandmaster, the whole leader. Actually, nowadays it's very rare to find somebody like that. You know, most of the time you call someone like that after you consult. You know, so I think when you have we, I mean, we make this kind of distinction to net or Sikon Iman. It means, you know, great deal, mainly because nowadays, you know, there is a lot of regional leaders all over the world besides Imam from different lineages. But of course, no one did more, or people make more than Imam to make Wing Chun well known all over the world, you know, mainly because his students. So that's why in a DVD distributed in the United States, we have included a part, one question is made by, to different people for they give you the opinion, not just in the martial arts field, but different people to give you the opinion about what exactly make someone a grandmaster or the grandmaster.
So, did you consider this movie as a milestone from Wing Chun movies?
Yes, because this movie is not a martial arts movie. It's a movie about martial arts, which is different. So all the structure, and you can see a lot of things in the movie, which is we cannot see in regular martial arts movie, you know. So of course, when the director, which is a very well known in the movie in industry, when he announced he was gonna make a Iman movie or a movie about the Grandmaster Ip Man, attract a lot of attention from everyone. You know, so I think this movie is represent a very important role for the martial arts because allows regular people understand better martial arts nature. The director, of course, the director, he is not a martial artist, but he made a very profound research to make the movie. In other words, in my opinion, he did his homework to make the movie. Of course, he put a lot of his ideas, but I think his idea was very good to represent mainly for people who is not belong to martial arts field to understand better how important is martial arts for the Chinese culture, or for Chinese society.
Marcelo, in many other occasions before, you talked about the feminization of the war. in particular when we were talking about Wing Chun. So, did you see this concept strong enough in the movie, The Grandmaster?
Well, I think when the director, Wong Kar-wai, he choose, elect Tony Leung to play Ip Man. He, of course, everybody in the movie industry knows Tony Leung is to Wong Kar-wai same way Leonardo DiCaprio is for Martin Scorsese. You know, so some directors have their favorite actors to represent the movie. But Tony Leung, his nature pretty much match with in my opinion, you know. Of course, I didn't met my Sikon personally, but according to my Sifu used to tell us about Sikon, Leung had this kind of softness who represent very well a man who give a lot of value to humanization of war, you know. So I think Tony Leung did a great job, you know. And of course, if you see the different editions of the movie, the role of the girl, the only is has sometimes even as more important than Tony Leung's paper. They have played, you know. So means sometimes that the director really want to interact with both, not the both sides. So I consider movie even the photography itself pretty much, you know, the human side, let's say, you know, a lot of human nature in the photography of the movie. So I think this movie represents very well the nature of the Wing Chun system, or Wing Chun style, if you want.
Thank you.
So when we talk about the martial arts society, we talk about the Mulan, martial arts community. So the film show us the Iman in a period that he lived in Fatsa, and he was great involved in the martial arts community. So, in the real life, that happened?
Well, we don't know that much what's going on those days in Fatsan. In the beginning, when the Sikon came from Fatsan to Hong Kong, one of the his friends, Lima, used to tell the students what's going on in Fatsan those days. Because Sikon himself, he rarely talk about the Fatsan time. Maybe Master Daryl has some stories from his father, because those days maybe Sikon tell something to Sipak, I don't know, you know. But according to my knowledge, after Stan, John Chen came from Hatsa in 1962, so then we know more about what's going on those days. But we know the martial arts community in Hatsa is pretty much different than in Hong Kong. So, I believe the director huge research to see what's going on those days. And if you not see his research matched pretty much what we did when you went to Fatsar, you know, and talked about the seafoods those days. What happened? Nowadays seafood, even nowadays seafood in Fatsar, don't have the kind of experience all these masters had in Fatsar, you know, because it was during the Republic period, not the communist period. It made a huge difference, you know. So, but I believe the move try to present greatness of the kind of society those days, you know. Really, you have kind of people which make moral in Fatsar very, very strong. Not just Wing Chun, many other famous styles like Lei Fat and Hong Ga on famous styles in Fatsar. We know from the second son about the fight when Imam fought against a northern Sifu. Sometimes people say it was a Tonglong's Sifu, other times Yan Zhao, we don't know exactly, no? Or Praying Mantis or Boko. Of course, in the movie, we mix up a little bit to represent, and in my opinion, when the director choose the idea, not a good fight, mainly because in other movies we have already this fight represented, you know, in the one Wilson Ip movie. Represent the fight already in Iman's house. So when they put the cake, then it represent a symbolic combat. I believe they did a great job, you know, because in this sense, people could appreciate martial arts on another level, just for in the fight scenes, a lot of excitement, but in a symbolic way. No? Same way sometimes that the director tried to compare a martial arts fight with the art of making love, you know? So sometimes have some mix in that, you know. For me, I consider this very good because then people can see martial arts in a different perspective, not just for fighting, you know? Which I think match pretty much what we try to show to people nowadays.
Thank you. Charles?
Sifu, just talking about this time in Fatsan, there is any research or then the confirm. It's like in the movie, we see like lost some local masters in a social meeting. Can you tell me that it's an example of a real practice? If they used to have the social meetings at least once in a while.
Yeah, one what is interesting in the movie, and I really appreciate. When we talk about Mogulan, not necessarily people identify those masters as temple masters, you know. Sometimes they look like a regular people entering in a restaurant or in any place, you know. So, but who belong to that group or the community, they know exactly who they are. But let's say regular people, when they look at those guys, sometimes they don't identify as martial arts master or Sifu, you know. So I really enjoy that part, because when you talk about Mola or talk about this kind of society or Mohab, what people the other director, Ang Lee, mentioned a lot of this in his movie, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. And, this kind of society is kind of very discreet. You know, that means it's a secret society, a special society. No, they gather in different places. And sometimes people don't identify them as a martial arts group. Of course, when they are well known, no way to hit it, right? But normally, you can gather among them without people identify them as a martial artist. It can be in very exquisite place, you know. Doesn't have to be in a mokon or in a gym, you know. In different environments, and that's what I think was very interesting when the director showed the place, you know, as a the Golden Pavilion, you know, as a place on the martial arts gathering among each other, you know. So very interesting, you know, because this match pretty much with the nature of my sifu, your sifu Moyat. That many times that Moyat tried to associate martial arts on the art of making love, you know. Of course, people don't understand as well and think that this is kind of, you know, a lease, at work. But in the movie, there is a dialogue between the father and the daughter, and he explained very well about this, you know. So that part, I particularly appreciate very much.